We go see. So let's, first of all, let's tune you up. Just a little. Good. And again. Good. And is your thumb loose? Making sure. Good. And let's do D string. Your hand over your high dot, which doesn't exist, but it's there, and put your, just rest your violin. That's good. Is that comfortable? So I really want you to feel that you can just go here and, can you just do that just a few times? That just, good. And we're just going to lift. Can you tap your first finger? Good. Good. Okay. Okay. So here we go. Let's just put all your music on the floor here. Music, don't you? Okay, and let's start with first movement. Good, so you're going to start at that, closer to the tip then. Yeah, okay, sorry, can we get lots of energy? To the frog. In your hand like this. Good. And we're just going to go up and down. And can we do windshield wipers? Just back and forth. Good. And can we straighten? again. Your bow goes to the wrong string, but you know where you are all the time, and that's the important thing. Okay. Okay, we'll do a couple things. When you go here, can you get all the way to the frog? Pink is your favorite color, or is it blue now?
It's blue.
Oh, okay. Okay, so we're gonna say here, to the frog, right? To frog. Okay, so let's, how about just once more there? Yeah. Up. Okay, that was very good. And then I wanna just, I don't know if it's so emergency pink, but we want to get that first finger there, right? Here. So first finger, the G, right? G to G. So how about, let's go just from this here. Do you know where that is from? Ba, ba, ba. And ba, ba. Ba, ba, ba. Understand the relationship.
And also, when you're putting it down, you're mm-hmm. both in tune.
Yes, that's what I loved about it, because you got the relationship. This is a minor six, but then I have to bring it back here. And that's how we play in tune. It's kind of understanding what's going on this fingerboard. You want to do that once more? Now, then this was very good, and then I think you ran out of, or you actually got too much steam here, because then you rushed here, and then your fingers bellowed. Down, ba, 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 down. So we're going to just write a pink thing here.
Steady.
That is a good word, steady. You want to do that, the whole section from, how about from the top of the page? Or yeah. You have it. It just kind of goes back into not as an efficient place. Slide up and back. See how we slide up? The knuckle up and back. Right. Feel that knuckle moving like that. Mm-hmm. Good. Oh, good. Okay. Now go back to the A. I'm going to show you one other thing. Now without the bow, we're going to just, can your finger just pop up and down? Oh, that's very good. Just slowly. That's right. We're just releasing this knuckle. Okay, and now vibrate the A. Good, and good. Good, and you're better off on the flatter part. Good, good. Okay, very nice. Okay, and how is your second movement? Good. That's good. That I like that place for your violin. Thank you. good. Is it better to do this as a slur here? And then this guy is can be in the one bow here. And good. Good. Well, this, if we hear, then this is up bow. Better. That's gonna yeah. So let's do that a few times. So this will come down bow, and I save the bow. And photo. Save the bow. That was very good. Now, on this one, we're going to just do one pink thing for the entire thing, the entire movement, in that we're going to just look at our frog changes, frog bow changes. And so we're going to do one, guys, that's right. You don't have to hang on. We're just going to go to the frog. Two, up, and across. 2, 1, frog. Good. And shoulder down. That's right. See, shoulder doesn't at all have to come back. chest, get comfortable here. See, you want the violin to be resting in your collarbone, right? Good. Be comfortable with your violin. Can you see my collarbone here? See how I rest it? That's good. Does that feel comfortable? Good. And then you don't have to press it down because it's resting on the shelf here. Good.
Thank you.
Really good, really good. Just, you know, your concentration is excellent. Just the first concentration here. I'll just put for our first section here, I'll just put eyeballs here. You have to know what's going on here. And really, I think whenever I'm pointing at your bow, it goes back into a really good place. So just maybe take a picture of your finger and just have it pointing at you. So, you know, so that you don't get stuck here. Because every time I point to you, then it goes back into a really good place. So just when we have, you know, just again, you see how we want to get to that tip. I think if you feel your ring finger, can we just feel your ring finger here? Just open A. Good, that's good. And then the E string. And then on the E string, you see, here you are on the A string. And you have to change your level. You have to change it. Good. That's good. And now the A string. And the G string. And the G. Good. Now go back to the E. Good. And adjust your bow. The ring finger. Yeah, that's really good. That's really good. So I would just practice, you know, just observe A, E, G, E. Just make a fun exercise for yourself where you're changing the strings. You want to try that now? So E, E, this once more. And just think of that ring finger. That will be a big help. And E string. A string. That E string. Fa, fa, fa. And yep, fa, fa, fa.
Yeah.
go, let's go. Oh. The passages that you did so well under tempo and one day start from first movement, one day go second, and one day third, so that you're switching, mixing it up. Okay. And I think your dad sent me the Boy Paganini, so I'm going to just take it now and put the fingerings in it for you so that you can start something new. Okay, so I'll turn this off.
Yes, we have.
Yep. Okay, so let's see. So let's do, you want to do this one first?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, how's your A? Okay. I'm just going to feel your fingers if they're staying really loose, and the D is. It's not going to come out on top correctly. So I have to keep the first finger in its place. B. Does that make sense? So as you do your code, A, D, E, good. Get that lighter finger. That's it. Double stops. If we don't push our fingers down, it's better in tune. because we have a bigger margin of error. Does that make sense? So if I push the finger down, it's only going to sound in one place. But if I'm very light here, see, if I go on a finger diet here, change the pitch. Did you hear that? So what we want to be able to do is, you see how, can you, I'm going to play my B out of tune and I want you to move my finger. Right, you see how easy? Now I'm going to play it again out of tune and I'm going to be you. To move, wasn't it? Yes? Or did it feel the same?
It hard.
It's hard to move. So that's what we want your fingers to be, easy to move. Are so good that you hear when it's out of tune. So that's good news. And what's the bad news? That it's out of tune. Does that make sense? Okay, so you have that's the good and the bad. So sometimes, it's really a problem when it's all bad news, but we want good news. Okay, so let's go on. We'll just keep going. Slowly, we're going to do. I'm going to play the C and then add it. good. So this is good. I keep my one down. Very good tritone. Good. Now, the F sharp is a little too high. It's too...
A little too high.
Yeah. So move your finger. Good. So then we have our tritone again. So... Okay, so this one is a little different. So I have to play, and then this second finger. What kind of six is this? That's great. Did you hear how it got better? And so what did you do to have it be better?
Light fingers.
Lighter fingers, and you listened, and then you just made the adjustments, right? So I think it would be really helpful to just review this because it's so good that we want it even better.
23rd,
okay, thank you.
I think.
Okay, close enough. And then if you want to add one,
24.
Okay. So if you want to add one more line for your new one here. These are very legato. Okay, so if you have time, you can add one more line here. Okay? Okey-doke. And positions. And we're doing E flat, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we'll go two, we'll start at the frog, and we're going to have the bow be very straight here. Okay. Very good. Oh, you got it really well. Now, I want to just go to these shifts. This is five. Now, we're going to shift on third finger. And here, I'm going to shift on four. So we're going to just isolate from here. That's it. Now here. Good. So we're going to So we're going to shift on three on the up bow, right? So we're going to do this. Can we isolate this shift? Up bow. So when we isolate a shift, we have to do it how many times?
Multiple.
Yes. How many multiples?
Seven.
Okay. So how about one, two, light finger, four, five, seven. Good. That was good. Okay. Now, then we go. So slowly up bow. Good. So watch. So two. So I can hear the changing tone for now. You can hear a little of the changing tone. This one, we shift on the down bow on four. So watch, I'll go four. Can we do that? Four. Good, again. Good. Good. was really good. So that's because it's a shifting book, right? We want to hear the shifts for now. So just do a little review on this one with the changing tones. And then we'll add just the two lines here, okay? You got it. Very good. Any questions?
Nope.